During this process, you saw a rock formation in the shape of the male organ, the penis. This was the symbol of the mystery schools of the generative force of creation. When you watch the movie again, pay attention to the symbology of the movie. Now, as the sun begins to sink even farther in the west, man and his little tribe goes to the water hole and confronts another group of primitive man, all in the form of the ape. And there's a confrontation. But you notice that no one was injured or killed. There was a lot of waving of arms, jumping up and down, grunting, screaming, and screeching, until the group that was at the watering hole and had already quenched their thirst moved away. And then the new group moved in. And then they scurried into the womb, signified by the cave. And there was more symbology there, as they all sat in the darkness with their eyes open in fear. And one of the female apes held a child to her breast. And you were seeing man in the transformation from ape to human. Primitive man evolving to the point where he could think. And then what happened in the movie, toward the dawn, you heard the humming of bees, millions of bees. And the beehive and bees were a prominent symbol in the mystery schools. It signifies societal cohesion. Industry. Now, not industry as you may know it in the manufacture of cars, but industry in working together in a societal form. In this case, the very basic rudiments of society. And as the sun again began to rise up in the east, signifying the dawn of the new man, the audience beheld an obelisk, a monolith. In front of the cave, or the womb, from which the apes emerged, and it appeared that the humming of the bees was emanating from this block of stone. Now notice I said three words: monolith, obelisk, and stone. All of these are significant symbols in the ancient mystery religions. And you saw that this was not God, because creation had already taken place. The world had been created. Plants and animals had been created, and primitive man existed on the earth before this monolith, this obelisk, this stone ever made its appearance. It is also known as the stone that you saw earlier, the generative force, or the penis. Now don't get all confused by this terminology. It will begin to make sense to you as we go along. It took me many years of study to understand what I am now imparting to you. You watched as the apes milled about in great excitement, and one, encouraged by another, signifying Adam and Eve. The one encouraging was the symbol of Eve. The one being encouraged was Adam. until he actually reached out and touched the face of the stone, and he was imparted intellect. You could tell that something significant had happened because the tone and the general volume of music changed at that point. And then the other apes began to touch and rub the statue. Now, most people that I knew attributed what happened to some extraterrestrial force. And they were receiving the exoteric interpretation, or that which is meant for the profane, those who are not illumined and cannot understand what it is they are seeing. But for the initiated, what they witnessed was the creation of the world by God and the impartation of knowledge to man, the forbidden knowledge, by Lucifer through his agent Satan. For in the religion of the mystery schools, they believed that man was held prisoner in the Garden of Eden by an unjust and vindictive God, and that man was not told by this unjust and vindictive God that he could have the same powers. And man was set free from the bonds of ignorance by Lucifer through his agent Satan, and many believe that the two are the same, and that's okay because maybe they are. And that through the gift of intellect, man himself will become God. Now, for those of you who understand what I am imparting to you now, you may not even have to listen any farther, for it explains everything that has ever happened in the history of man, and everything that is happening now, and all that is to happen in the future. As it progressed, you saw the first primitive man form the first original thought with the use of the gift of intellect, when he squatted in the dust and picked up a bone and flopped the bone over and saw it hit a rib, and the rib flew up into the air, and he looked at it, and he flopped it over to the other side and hit another piece of rib bone, and flew up into the air, and you could see the wheels turning in the mind of this primitive individual as he lifted the thigh bone and then struck down in front of him and watched bones fly. And then he struck again and again, and then he crushed the skull of the dead animal that was lying in front of him. And you notice that the portrayal of this was absolutely accurate, because the next thing that happened was that this new gift, this intellect, and this original thought led to the murder of another primitive human being. In this case, of the tribe that had not been given the gift of intellect, did not have the ability to use a bone as a weapon because they had not made the connection. And you watched in the symbology of that movie the murder of Abel by his brother Cain.